In this video, we're going to talk about solenoid valve troubleshooting. Here at Haas, we use several different types of solenoid valve in various configurations. There are three things all these solenoid valve requires in order to function correctly. They must have a good electrical connection, a consistent airflow, and must be free from contamination. If you're getting ready to replace a solenoid because the device it's operating is not working, hit the pause button and make sure the solenoid you're replacing is for the right reason. The questions you should be asking are, is there an issue with the power to the solenoid? Is the airflow to the machine correct? Are you having an intermittent problem with the solenoid due to inadequate air? Do you have a contaminated solenoid? All these questions must be answered before replacing the solenoid. We have made several videos which cover contamination and other aspects of solenoid extensively. You can find the link in the description below. A solenoid valve is a simple device. It is an electromechanically operated valve. This valve is connected to an electrical coil, and when the coil energizes, it moves the valve up and down, and that controls the flow of air through the device it's operating. In this situation, we have a problem with the turret clamp and unclamp solenoid working intermittently. Let's look at how we troubleshoot whether the solenoid is getting what it needs to function correctly. As I've mentioned earlier, they must have a good electrical connection, consistent airflow, and free from contamination. Locate the decal on the door of the comm cabinet. Find the location of the solenoid you need to troubleshoot. The first requirement is airflow. The air coming into the machine must be clean, dry, and have adequate pressure and flow. If not, you'll probably have issues with these solenoids down the road. To begin, we'll check the air pressure at the input and output of the solenoid. Turn the main air off and release the blow-off valve. Disconnect the airline from the input side of the solenoid. Slowly open the main air valve and monitor the flow. The air should be crisp and dry and show no restriction. Turn the main air off again, plug the air hose back in, and turn on the main air. Disconnect the air hose from the output line, cover the fitting for about 10 seconds, then release your finger. You should not feel any back pressure. If you feel back pressure, it means the spool went into an intermediate state due to insufficient air. That does not mean you change the solenoid. Start by making sure the machine has sufficient air. If the issue is not resolved, then disconnect the solenoid and follow steps to clean out any contamination. We've made a video on how to properly clean the solenoid. Check the description below for the link of that video. Now, if there's no internal leak, manually activate the solenoid override by pressing the button a couple of times. You should hear similar pressure coming from the output side as you did on the input side. If your solenoid does not have a manual override button, use an M code to command a solenoid to open and close. Next, check the electrical circuit. With the input air line plugged in and the main air to the solenoid is on, go to MDI, type the command for the device the solenoid controls and command it, allowing air to get to the output side of the solenoid. If the solenoid works correctly, we will confirm two things. One, there's 120 volts present throughout the circuit, and two, we get the pressure and flow we need to adequately operate the device. If the solenoid doesn't work when you command it, here are a few telltales that it's not actuating. You won't hear a click from the solenoid valve opening. You don't hear air pressure leaking from the output side of the solenoid, or maybe the device icon did not appear on screen. That means the I/O board never received the command, or there is no power to turn on the solenoid. Make sure you command the correct device you're troubleshooting. Go to Parameter Diagnostics, then the I/O output page. Find the device your troubleshooting. Command the M code again from MDI. If the bit changed from 0 to 1, the command was sent. The next step is to check the cable from the I/O board to the solenoid. Make sure the connections are plugged in correctly and the pins in the connectors are properly seated. And make sure the cable is not damaged. Use a voltage detector or multimeter with needle tip probes to check for voltage at the I/O board as well as the solenoid cable when the M code is activated. When using a multimeter with needle tip probes, always insert the probe tips from the back of the connector and always measure the voltage with the solenoid connected. If the solenoid still does not operate, connect it to an electrical connector of a known working solenoid and activate that solenoid. If the solenoid starts working, do not replace it. There's a problem with the particular electrical circuit you're testing. If the voltage is correct and the solenoid does not operate, check the coil for continuity. If there is no continuity, then replace the solenoid. For more information on solenoids or any service-related topics, visit haascnc.com/service, and thanks for watching.